it into that push up in that deep back bend. And the real characteristic of Serbian Shire's work is that she's so very, very neat. Everything is absolutely perfect, and rarely do you see this girl make a mistake. Makes things very difficult for the judges if they're looking to take marks away. She really doesn't give them that opportunity too often. And finishes with a flourish, that illusion turn straight into a forward roll. And again, perhaps you'd like to see Serebrenskaya take a few more risks. But really, the exercises that she does them so well, so cleanly. And I think consistency has become her watchword in the last couple of years. You hardly ever see this girl drop the apparatus. Look at the extension on those jumps, those turning split leaps, the legs going way past splits. And again on that split jump. And that's the difference between Serebrenskaya and some of the other gymnasts in this final. And 9.95 for her. I'm not looking particularly happy. In the Grand Prix tournament in Corbeil just a few weeks ago, she was picking up tens. That the judges will be looking for in this rope final. Three sets of skipping and a three leap series through the rope. That was one just there. Gymnasts must include that or there's heavy deductions. Nice hand balance through the rope. Notice the gymnast doesn't go through the vertical. That's not allowed in rhythmic gymnastics. So walkovers and cartwheels, not allowed. And it accepted acrobatic movements which don't go through the vertical. Finishes with that split jump to catch the rope on the back of the leg, using the momentum of the leg to trap the rope and stop it from moving. Beautiful extension on those jumps. Very high, good elevation. Plenty of expression in that routine by Elena Vitrychenko. The judges not seeing fit to mark her as high as her countrywoman, Serebrenskaya. Larisa Lukianenko, one of the oldest gymnasts in this competition. 22 now. No. third at the World Championships last year in Vienna. Dramatic gymnast. So something of a mercurial career. Did well to come back a couple of years ago after a serious ankle injury. Broke her ankle in training at one of the major competitions. But back with a vengeance now. That throw looked as if it was going off the area. Did well to retrieve it. Not quite cleanly through the rope there on that turning split jump. Such a flexible gymnast, and there's all the evidence you'll ever need of that. Lovely routine, very dramatic. Couple of occasions where she wasn't quite cleanly through the rope on some of the jumps. And that's where she will lose marks. But apart from that, very exciting gymnast to watch. Look at that for flexibility. But she did lose marks, 9.9 the score for Larisa Lukyanenko. And their confirmation of the results in this rope final. Another gold for Serebrenskaya. Agrisko takes silver, and Diana Popova, good to see her in the medals. We'll be back in just a minute. And welcome back. The second final of these European Championships. And first to go, Yana Batushina from Russia. Batushina, one of the youngest gymnasts in this final. She's just 16. She's come up through the ranks of a junior international competition and really is a crowd favourite. With great charisma. She also has the technical difficulty in her work to match that. Jumping over the ball on the bounce up. And no bobber there on that double turn. The leg very high in front and held rock solid. Control. She doesn't even bat an eyelid. Batushina making it look so easy. That routine absolutely packed with difficulty. Almost a risk in every catch. Look at that. Great height on the leap, good amplitude, great flexibility. As the Russians are concerned, she is one of their great hopes for an Olympic medal. And 9.983 her score. Certainly showing her promise here. She was second by the narrowest of margins in the overall competition to Serebrenskaya, and maybe in Atlanta she can go one better. Elena Vitrychenko from the Ukraine. Ukrainian team, something of a family affair. Vitrychenko's mother is the team coach here. And Serebryanskaya's mother on the judging panel. Lovely turns. Very smoothly through the turns, Vitrychenko. Spotted that very well, the side leap. Backward roll to trap catch the ball.
Thank you.
And that was a lovely exercise from Vitrychenko. Very smooth, very fluid, and extremely expressive. Sixth at the World Championships in Vienna, finished out of the medals in these apparatus finals. Certainly been showing some good form lately, finished second in the Grand Prix in Corbeil earlier this month. At the moment, she is living in the shadow of her teammate, Serebryanskaya. It seems that nothing she does can take her beyond the marks of the world and now European champion. And here she is, gold in the all-round competition and gold on rope. Now what can she do here? Control on that hand balance, straight into that deflection. Great height on those leaps. Almost seems to hang in the air, almost like Michael Jordan. Very good elevation. Trained at the Dorogina School of Gymnastics in the Ukraine. Her coach, Ilya Dorogina, three times world champion during the 70s, and Serebryanskaya showing all the promise that she is going to follow in her coach's footsteps. Such good flexibility, good extension on those jumps. Fouetté turns, barely puts a foot out of place, this girl. And the judges seem to think so. Also, a straight 10 for Serebryanskaya, the first of these apparatus finals. Mm-hmm. Russia have in answer to that? Marina Zaripova is about to tell us. Zaripova, originally from Uzbekistan, now trains at Novogorsk, just outside Moscow, with Irina Venna. Zaripova, fifth in the World Championships in Vienna last year. Third at Europeans last time out. And third again here in the all-round competition. Nice trap catch. So flexible, this girl. And the nice thing about her work in the last couple of years is that she has learned to control that flexibility. When she was younger, it was the only factor in her work. And now she simply makes use of it. She has got other qualities. She finished third in the all-round. Another great Russian hope for the Olympic Games. Right in the medals on that one, though, 9.9. So five. Confirmation there. Another gold for Serebrenskaya. She's really cleaning up at the moment. No one coming near on that one with that stroke 10. Plenty more rhythmic gymnastics still to come. Join us in a moment. On to the club's final. We've already seen Katerina Serebrenskaya from the Ukraine take gold on rope and ball. Perhaps Yana Batershina from Russia, a little bit hard done by in that ball final. Nevertheless, on to clubs. First up, Elena Vitrychenko from the Ukraine. Vitrychenko, silver medal in the ball final. Now, traditionally, this is her strongest exercise. Last time out in Thessalonica, she really cleaned up in these apparatus finals. Took gold on all four pieces of apparatus, but has been losing ground since then to her teammate, Serebrenskaya. Toe there on that double turn. Good extension. And good control on that double throw of the clubs into the illusion turn. Really does send these clubs flying, Vitrychenko. Certainly, they do hurt when they come down. Slight adjustment there. And 1.95 the score for Vitrychenko. Make a couple of small adjustments of the clubs on those catches, and that's perhaps where she lost the marks. So far, no medals for Zaripova in these apparatus finals. But she has got a very strong clubs exercise. Got a 10 in the all-round competition for this routine. Must keep the clubs moving at all times. The apparatus is static. Well, the judges are taking the marks away. Shinny turn, straight as that hand balance. And good wrist on that final catch. And really, the judges who we saw there halfway through the exercise will have their work cut out to take any marks away from her on that one. Very cleanly through the throws. See, is the Zaripova making any adjustments? And that's a very difficult catch. With one club already in the hand, so easy for the club to bounce out. Particularly in that very deep flexion that she was in. Certainly very happy with that. Another perfect 10 for Amina Zaripova. Natalia Lipkovskaya from Russia. Relatively new on the rhythmic gymnastics scene. Didn't make it through to the all-round competition by virtue of the fact that Zaripova and Batyrshina were the two Russian gymnasts in that all-round final. She did make two apparatus finals at the World Championships in Vienna last year. And one of them was with this piece of apparatus, the clubs. On that balance. Goes right through to the toe. And that is fantastic control from Lipkovskaya. This gymnast coached by Oksana Kostina's trainer. Former world champion, suddenly no longer with us, but almost like watching Kostina work. Very similar characteristics. Very well-prepared gymnast, very toned. With a very, very good command of all the body elements of rhythmic gymnastics. And serious throughout that routine, Lipkovskaya, that breaks into a smile at the end. Good appreciation from the crowd. They know it was difficult. Good elevation on the leaps. Good extension right through the legs. And I think there'll be plenty more to come from this gymnast. She's only 16. The big internationals all very new to her still. But certainly a talent to watch out for in the future. 9.95 her score, and the crowd don't like that. They think it should have been a straight 10. And someone no stranger to those perfect 10 scores, lately anyway, is Katerina Serebrennskaya, reigning world champion and now European champion. Now, like Zaripova, she also got a 10 in the all-round competition with this exercise. Remember, the gymnasts actually don't carry the scores through. They start here in the finals with a clean slate. The floor brilliantly on those leaps. Three jumps, and she's practically covered two sides of the carpet. Chanet catching that flexion. Double throw for that unusual finishing position. Another clean, clean exercise from Serebrennskaya. Perhaps not the difficulty there of Lipkovskaya, but it is almost perfect to watch. Does finish everything off to the nth degree. Slight adjustment there on the catch. This girl says her favourite thing in the whole world is pizza. Well, I guess she won't be able to eat too many of those until after Atlanta. I'm not happy with that, 9.966. That's her first silver medal of these championships. And Amina Zaripova takes the gold in this club's final, with Tchenko the bronze and silver for Serebrennskaya. We've got the ribbon final coming up. Join us in just a minute. As always, Tatiana Agurysko from Belarusia. Get things started on the ribbon. Agurysko, seventh in the all-round competition. Yet here so far. Good coverage of the floor there on those three turning jumps, and good elevation and flexibility. Nice pullback. The ribbon just stopped on the floor there. It's momentarily very static. Double illusion turn. difficult throw. Very small throw, just using the stick, not using the actual ribbon itself as a lever. Quite hard to control that. Well, nice way to finish for Ogrisco. No mistakes, nice clean exercise. Good use of the music, good body movements, very neat and tidy. Example there of just how flexible these gymnasts are and how strong. The legs so high, almost touching the nose, while still managing to control that pirouette. And then of course is how the gymnasts get their marks. Judges looking for originality and risk. 9.916, the score for Ogrisco. If you're wondering why some of these scores seem slightly peculiar, it's because of the first time here at these championships, they're using five judges on the panel and averaging the middle three scores. Usually it's just the middle two, so we've had some slightly odd scores to say the least. Larissa Lukyanenko. Now so far, she's been very unlucky. Finished out of the medals. Control on that balance, holding it beyond 3 seconds so she can get the marks from the judges. Throws, split leap throw, straight into the pullback. A lovely finish from Lukyanenko. Great deal of difficulty in that exercise. Such a strong gymnast, very muscly, but also very graceful. Great control on all the body movements. Very dynamic, slightly dramatic exercise. 9.933, Lukyanenko's score. Coached by Marina Lobach, Lukyanenko, former Olympic champion of the sport. Serbianskaya slightly upset her record in the club's final. Only managed a silver there. Thank you. rhythm going through the hand balance. You mustn't let the rhythm stop. For the final throw. And if you want to finish with a flourish, I guess that's the way to do it, with that throw, triple roll to finish. Very expressive exercise, very dynamic exercise by Serebrianskaya. It's quite amazing how this gymnast manages to keep going competition after competition without putting a foot wrong. It's hard to see how the judges can take marks away from her, really. It's almost like she's now found her standard. She knows what her limits are. And she's decided to go all out to produce the perfect routine, and that's what she's doing. Although the code will change after the Olympic Games. And if she wants to keep her position at the top of the tree, Serebrianskaya will have to update those exercises, make them slightly more difficult, take slightly more risks. Well, 9.95 the score. So she goes into first place, but for my money, that exercise wasn't quite as good as Lukinenko's. And the Bulgarians' lone representative here in these finals, Diana Popova. Got a 9.832 in the all-round competition with this exercise. She'll certainly have to improve on that if she's to get into the medals here. Routine must have slow parts and then the dynamic bits.